Hello and welcome to this video. In this video, we will analyze the FedEx stock, which trades under the ticker symbol FDX. First, we will provide an overview of most recent financial results. And after that, we will look at FedEx stock from a value investment centric perspective. In the end, we will look at the current price and other key factors to determine whether it is the right time to buy the FedEx stock or not. Before we go ahead, here is the disclaimer. I am not a financial advisor, and the information presented in this video is just based on my own research and shows the way I interpret the facts. But I am sure that this information will help you tremendously in doing your own research. So according to TipRanks, based on 21 Wall Street analysts offering 12-month price targets for FedEx in the last 3 months, the average price target is $307.80, with a high forecast of $369, and a low forecast of $250. The average price target represents a 40.36% change from the last price of $219.29. So one of the major recent developments is the launch of autonomous truck commercial pilot as a result of collaboration between FedEx, PACCAR and Aurora. So PACCAR has teamed up with Aurora, which is a leading autonomous driving technology company, and FedEx, one of the largest transportation and logistic companies in the world, to launch a commercial pilot of autonomous trucks in line haul trucking operations. This is the first collaboration of its kind between a truck manufacturer, an autonomous technology developer and a logistics provider. So starting today, PACCAR's autonomously enabled trucks configured with the Aurora Autonomous Driver will haul FedEx loads between Dallas and Houston, a 500-mile round trip along the I-45 corridor. The trucks will operate autonomously with a backup driver for additional safety. PACCAR is pleased to partner with industry leader FedEx and Aurora on this innovative project, said Joshua Rich, PACCAR Chief Technology Officer. But along with the bullish news, there are some bearish news also, such as the shortage of labor. So according to FedEx COO Raj Subramaniam, the impact of constrained labor markets remains the biggest issue facing our business, as with many other companies around the world, and was the key driver of our lower than expected results in the first quarter. FedEx said that its quarterly results were drilled by $450 million due to labor shortages alone. Notably at its ground segment, the company estimated a shocking 600,000 packages across the FedEx network are being rerouted because of the inability to find labor. And this is not all. In fact, FedEx stock suffered its biggest sell-off in 18 months as analysts slashed targets after another disappointing earnings report. So this is in contradiction with what the analysts on TipRanks are thinking, who have given it a strong buy rating. Therefore, I believe it is the time to analyze the FedEx stock so that we can look at the FedEx stock from a long-term value investment-centric perspective. If you watch this video till the end, you will understand my whole thought process, which I use to shortlist stocks from a value-centric investment perspective as an experienced investor. Now let's analyze the FedEx stock through our 14 value-centric dimensions to evaluate its feasibility as a long-term value investment. I will also be interested to see how much score we get out of 100 for the FedEx stock. So as always, I will also be interested to see if we can get a score of over 75% over the time frames of 3, 5 or 10 years and see the parallel or correlation between our feasibility analysis and the opinions of analysts. In other words, I will be interested in seeing how well our dimensions converge to the same conclusion as the analysts on TipRanks who have given it a strong buy rating. And later on, if our dimensional analysis validates its feasibility as a long-term investment, we will look at the current state of the market through the lens of 6 critical dimensions to gauge if it is the right time to accumulate FedEx stock or shall we wait for the market to offer it to us for a cheaper price. So let's go ahead and analyze FedEx stock via the 14 dimensions of value-centric investment feasibility. So first of all, looking at the top level numbers and percentages. So the current price of FedEx stock is around $224. The current market cap of FedEx is $59 billion. The PE ratio over the trailing 12 months is 11.5. The current PEG ratio over the trailing 12 months is 0.7. The earnings per share over the trailing 12 months is 19.45. The current price to book ratio is 2.4, and the current price to sales ratio is 0.7, while the current price to free cash flow ratio is 19.8. And over the past 5 years, the average yearly revenue growth was 8%, the average yearly asset growth was 16%, the average yearly equity growth was 5%, and the average yearly net income growth was 48%, while the average yearly liability growth was 23%. So let's look at the actual growth in revenue now. So the total revenue grew from $35 billion to $69 billion from 2010 to 2020. And from 2015 to 2020, it grew from $47 billion to $69 billion. And the total free cash flow increased from $357 million to $1 billion from 2010 to 2015, while it dropped from $1 billion to -$771 million from 2015 to 2020. And now let's see if FedEx can pay its long-term liabilities with the free cash flow over the past 5 years or not. So looking at the free cash flow over the past 5 years from 2016 till 2020, the cumulative free cash flow was negative over the past 5 years looking back from 2020, and it means that FedEx won't be able to pay its liabilities with cumulative free cash flow from the past 5 years. And as we can see, since 2014, this graph has been on a steady decline that does not look good. I like to see this graph over 1, meaning the company should be able to pay its long-term liabilities with the cumulative cash flow from over the past 5 years. And now let's have a look at the average, minimum, and maximum ROE over the past 5 years. Feel free to pause the video to look at these numbers over the past 10 years and over the past 3 years. So the average ROE over the past 5 years was 15%. The maximum ROE was recorded in 2018, which was 26%. The minimum ROE during the past 5 years was recorded in 2019, as we can see over here, and it was 3%. The average ROE over the past 5 years was 14%, which is just a little bit lower than what we will like to see in a company before investing, which is 15%. So this dimension is a fail by a narrow margin. Feel free to pause the video and look at these numbers for ROIC for the past 5 years also, for the past 10 years, and also for the past 3 years. And now let's have a look at the diluted shares outstanding. So looking at the total shares outstanding, the total number of shares reduced from 314 million to 261 million from 2010 till 2020. And we can see that the growth rates were either zero or negative during the past 10 years, except for 2011 only, where 1% new shares were issued. And the maximum number of shares outstanding were in 2011, which were 317 million. And the minimum number of shares outstanding were in 2020, which were 261 million. And as far as the PE ratio is concerned, we can see that in 2016, the average PE ratio was around 24. In 2017, the average PE ratio was around 17. In 2018, the average PE ratio was around 14.5. In 2019, the average PE ratio was 71.51. And in 2020, the average PE ratio was 26.49. We still have some months to go in 2020, and we will look at the PE ratio range for 2021 so far later in the video. And the graph of total current assets over total current liabilities and total assets over total liabilities is also very important. And we can see that both these graphs remained over 1 for the past 10 years, which is great for the company of this size. And now let's have a look at the overall score of the 14 value-centric dimensions for the last 10 years, the last 5 years, and the last 3 years. These scores show the feasibility of a stock as a long-term value-centric investment over different time frames. Feel free to pause the video if you want to look at each one of these dimensions and the result of it in a certain time frame. So we get a score of 43%, 50%, and 36% over the past 10 years, 5 years, and 3 years respectively, which is well below the score of 75%, which we look for in a company. And now we look at the 6 dimensions of market state to see what the smart money thinks and how the current price is as compared to the past years and so on. This gives us an awareness of the way different market participants think, and it also puts things further into perspective. Now let's look at what the smart money thinks, meaning the hedge fund activity, so that we can see if the result of our analysis contradicts with the opinion of hedge fund managers or not. So looking at the hedge fund activity, we can see that the smart money or hedge fund managers agree with me, and they are selling the FedEx stock continuously since September 2020. Since the financial stress is becoming more severe for FedEx, so our analysis is supported by the activity of hedge funds. So as far as the PE ratio range is concerned, so the PE ratio has dropped significantly since 2019, as we can see. And currently in 2021, the stock is on sale, since the PE ratio range so far in 2021 is between 16.85 and 11.87. And as far as the current price is concerned, we can see that the maximum price of FedEx stock was reached on May 28th, 2020, which was $313.15. Afterwards, we can see that the price has dropped significantly due to labor shortage and other issues, such as the unsatisfactory financial reserves and so on. I never catch falling knives, and therefore I am not going to buy the FedEx stock at the current price. Therefore, we conclude that FedEx stock is not a good value investment at this point, and we need to wait for the PE ratio to come down below 20 so that we can start accumulating again. Please let me know in the comments below, do you like the FedEx stock or not? Also, would you buy the FedEx stock at current price or not? I hope that you like the content of this video. If you would like to see such videos with my unbiased opinion and my own unique style of analyzing stocks, please drop a like, subscribe to my channel, and press the notifications bell and select the option all so that you can get the notifications of the upcoming videos as soon as they are released. And I will see you in the next video. Bye.